I'm going to be working with some stamps and some little bits and pieces of paper. This is from my charcoal pencil. I cannot see a paper that I don't like, so I'm going to be putting little strips over here and over there. And also, I'm going to be using my Gelli prints. These are, in case that you haven't heard about them, these are monoprints done by a gelatin pad or a Gelli plate, which you can purchase in many sizes. Basically, you add your paint and you print your paper by adding and removing the paint on the plate. I just love it. It's just fascinating. There's not a single one that is repeated, even if you use the same patterns. And like I said in another video, if you don't like what you have right now, you're only one more print away from perfection. You can always change them at any point. So anyway, I am going to be using this, which is made in the Gelli paper, which is a very thin, kind of waxy paper. And I'm going to be collaging this onto my surface and adding some stamps probably. I might use this or an old plastic credit card or the brayer. Whatever you have handy is good. So without much more introduction, here we go. One of the things that you can do with the Gelli paper or your prints or any other tissue kind of paper is that you can wrinkle it and then flatten it. That's something I like to do. You just have to make sure that the wrinkles are also well attached to the canvas. And it gives you one more layer of texture. You can do the whole thing or you can just do a little bit. It all depends on what you like. But I think it looks really cool. I might wait a little bit for the medium to dry, and then I'm going to apply some stamps. But I am very happy with the results of this, and it doesn't look like anything that was printed the way I had it before when I started. And it is a very easy way and a lot of fun to start your piece. So I will be right back. I'm going to add some purple now. Okay, now the following is going to be a chalk finish paint. There are several brands out there. This is the craft size, and it is a lot of fun. Since I have matte medium in pretty much everything, it's going to be fine. But it is also a really nice contrast when you have everything satin and then you add a chalk texture. Some contrast. I'm going to go around with an antiquing or distress stain, and I'm making sure that it's not too wet, so it's not going to be a really, really big stain, because I just want a small amount. And if the sponge is very wet, then you will have way too much. All right. If this is the first time you visit my channel, I hope you found something that will make you click that subscribe button. And don't forget to select from the menu to receive notifications, so you will get an email every time I upload a video. And I will see you in the next one. Keep your paintbrush wet. Bye-bye.